Need to serve. Peasant care salute from members received. Testify, James, the board.
Welcome back. To our third women's final of the day. Between Alison Thompson of England and Tessa Tersnes from the Netherlands. So, 2-0 in this first game.
3-2.
So, 3-2 to Alison Thompson. Fresh back from this lunch, I'll hand you back over to Karen Roach.
Thanks. Stroke to Alison Thompson. That's a very good play.
5-2.
Alison was a good 5-2 lead. Tessa Tersnes really threw everything at Alison there, but Alison was able to counter, defend, and just keep the rallies going. As Tessa commented on Tessa's game last night, her striker was absolutely superb. I thought she'd struggle with the mobility of Alison Thompson, because Alison, 19 years of age, is a superb athlete. And a superb competitor as well.
And I have 3-7.
But I have to say, I was really impressed with Tessa's Her backhand particularly is absolutely beautiful, and she's got very good instinctive posts. Just look how hard she has to work to get a point. Very good play from both players.
4-7.
4-7. Slightly fortunate nick there.
5-7.
But again, if you put the ball in the right place, you're not going to get a nick. 5-7. Tess is a little bit annoyed, more with herself than the referee, I think. I think Tessa thought it was good. They're sometimes very hard to see when they hit that angle up on the high up. And she slightly jerked her back on there.
10-5, game ball.
Just rushed it a bit. Didn't get her body behind it. 10-4. Oh, 11-5. First game to Alison Thompson. Alison's the world ranking 82, 19 years of age. And her Dutch opponent, Tessa Tersluis, 722 in the world, and age 21. An interesting contrast. Tessa has lovely racket control, beautiful backhand, and plays very nice balls, but they only work against someone who's not really, who doesn't have the level of mobility that Alison has. I think it's going to be a long, hard game for Tess, to be honest. But we wait and see. Take a short break and rejoin for the second game. Alison leading 1-0. The two ladies return to the court. See, Alison's dad coming up a few steps to take his place in the audience. Alison's dad, Alan, is an absolutely superb master squash player. Scottish international. Squash player and the Scottish Masters, multi-international, very multi-international. He's so good that he's playing in all age groups, so far younger than his own age group. Tessa has those lovely boasts.
one lot.
They work well if she can sell a dummy to her husband, which she did in that case. A good riposte from Alison, getting to the drop and counter dropping. A nice post. High risk shot behind you, but it works. 2-0. Really good squash. Beautiful. That's a lovely shot. Absolutely brilliant. Rally. Attack, counter attack. Beautiful defense. Choices really, and opted for the instinctive one. I had a brief chat with her last night talking about it. She's such a naturally instinctive squash player. You've got the contrast between the player who's well coached, who's playing the ball up and down the walls, playing structured, functional squash, and then you have these instinctive players who, you know, suddenly throw in unusual posts and drops, as Tessa does a lot. Oh, that's unlucky. She likes that tickle post in the front. She just gets up to it and plays a tickle post. The problem with it really is that you're very vulnerable. If your opponent reads it and gets up to it, the whole court is open. So it's for occasional use only. It's probably beyond the prescription. That's a lovely, turning into be a lovely competitive game of squash. Slightly contrasting styles, which makes for a nice competition. Tessa is making a face at herself, annoyed. It's okay to be annoyed with yourself as long as you use it productively. Lovely drop from Alison. Took the ball early, took the pace. off it.
6-5.
Touched it onto the front wall, into the nick. 6-5. Are helping keeping the game moving. Oh, that's a poor drop. Probably wasn't the right shot to play anyway. 75, 7-5. Absolutely beautiful. Change the angle on that. Alison's scampering to cover a drop into the backhand side. And she just flicked her wrist and moved it to the other side. 7-0. Meat and drink to someone with Tessa's racket control. 8-7. Occasionally gets herself caught where she's flat-footed and trying to play a shot instead of moving her legs. Clearing space to play them properly. And she was just unlucky there.
9-8.
9-8. Drop. Her backhand drives on the backhand. Power and control, perfect length on them are just lovely. And then after three of them, she attacked them beforehand and played a drop. Very well constructed point. No, too much on the stretch.
And out, 10-9, game ball.
Alison's apologising, I'm not sure what for. Probably a slight miss hit on the on her post. An easy decision for the referee. 10-0. Be important for Tessa to win this. In the game. Oh, lovely, lovely, lovely shot. The crowd really appreciated that. Brilliant drop. Into the nick. 11-10. Great defense from Alison.
Okay. This left. This left. 11-10.
Oh, that's tumbling just for a let. Alison's fine. The two girls smile and acknowledge that it was a total accident. and Dignity Resort. That's a brilliant job. That's a great winning point. Absolutely superb play. Both girls are playing super squash, and it's a joy to play in this game. It's a joy to watch it, rather. I'd love to be able to play in it, but I sort of was born in the wrong sex, so we'll just enjoy watching them play. So one game all. And they both got out to get guidance and encouragement, but I don't know what they need to do differently myself. We'll return in a few, in less than a minute anyway.
One game all,
Tessa just loses serving. Tessa just loses serving. Again, didn't get her feet adjusted. Played it moving backwards, flat footed. Brilliant recovery from Alison, who was bombarded initially. Again, Tessa took that ball far too early.
True love.
Could have set herself much better. True love. True love. Three very quick points, really.
True love.
For two, it was Nick.
And now, 1-3.
1-3. Again, I noticed that the game yesterday. Tessa played a number of drops, and really, she should have driven them. Long, hard, straight drive there. Any of three shots would have produced the point. Expression "the biter bit" came to mind when someone who plays trickle balls got a trickle balls played against her. Alison did very well that time. That's served too long, and Tessa just jumped on it. She drove like I told her to
three,
do.
Five.
Not that she was listening or anything, but she actually drove it too short. Was lucky to get the point. But again, a fascinating rally.
Three,
Ah, lovely backhand.
4-5.
Just unlike the last men's match, which Reed failed sparkle, this is absolutely engrossing game of squash. A lovely backhand. 6-4. So one game, Alison leading 6-4. Absolutely brilliant.
7-4 left box.
Rally and squash between both players, working very hard and pushing each other to the limits. 7-4.
Just left.
Actually, the referee and Marker are having an easy ride in this game. There's no really contentious decisions. Both players are creating clearing space for each other, making for an engrossing competition. That gave a relatively easy point to Alison there. Ah, yes, well played.
And that, 5-8.
5-8. Alison didn't expect Tessa to get to that ball. I wasn't quite prepared for the next one when she did. Again, there's at least 4 points on this game alone that Tessa played where her feet were static, but there was no movement in her. Post. She really has that front court trickle post natural shot in her locker that she probably overuses, but look, it's good to use occasionally. That's great length, great depth from Alison, superb.
10-6,
game ball. Tessa should have boasted that one. Alison, so competitive. Actually, both are superb competitors. So they're going off for a break. Right in the score, and we'll be back with you in just a few moments. Thank you. Just looking at the sheet while the two young ladies are taking a little bit of fluid and a lot of advice from their respective coaches. The game we have coming up at 4:45, which may well not be quite on time, has Declan James, world number 41 from England, against his compatriot Joe Lee, world number 55. I was very impressed with Declan James' squash yesterday as he beat Ian Sure. Very relatively comfortably in a very good game. I played very good squash. So that's to be looking forward to. And then the last of the quarterfinals of the girls, Anna Kalmundova from Czech Republic against Rachel Chadwick from England at 5:45 in an hour's time. So, but for the moment, let's concentrate on what we're enjoying. Alison Thompson, two games to go. And Tessa Tressler from the Netherlands. Tessa puts the ball down unnecessarily. One down. This is inclined to play enough of those backhands down the backhand side. Great length from Alison, absolutely brilliant. Three game lead. Comfortable cushion she has already. That's unlucky. Alison looking at her position of her
one, three.
Body relative to her feet to see why she put that drop down, but I don't think there's anything too majorly wrong. Maybe didn't bend her knees enough. Oh, how quickly things change. The missed drop.
2-3.
And a quick feed off a return of serve, and it's 2-3 from three levels. 2-3. Tess was just a little slow to get moving on to get to that. 4-2. Absolutely brilliant. Pulled her opponent right into the corner and then played the cross court. And then flicking the ball up, she flicks it straight at her father. Says, "I'm sorry, Dad." How good a squash player you are. You don't upset your dad. You certainly don't attack him with a squash ball. Not to be recommended. That's all right. He's been hit by many a squash ball in his day. Actually, her dad was a touring professional squash player in his younger days. And as I said, one of the most respected master squash players. I'm not sure if he's won a world master squash title, but I wouldn't be surprised if he did. Oh, that's great scrambling.
And 6-3.
Tessa should try and avoid getting into scramble matches. with Allison because he's just so quick, so fleet. It's a brilliant recovery. Yeah. Now that's the sort of shot that her father plays very well, those high floats. Pull the opponent back down the court and give yourself a time to recover. 7-3.
Eight three.
I think all the very hard work and making Tessa really work hard in the last two games has paid off finally. She's going for quick winners now. That one was successful, but the odds are tend to be against it. I become quite happy when someone is going for winners. Even though they'll succeed sometimes, the percentages go against you. As I know, because I always do it. Ah, oh, that's a nice. And she breathes a sigh of relief that Alison hadn't covered it. 5-8. Still a very substantial lead at this level of squash, where points are not easily won or lost. That's brilliant play from Alison, superb. Tessa knew what was coming and was on her bike, but she needed a moped for that one. 10-5 match ball, an absolutely, thoroughly entertaining game. Really enjoyed by the audience here. Two superb squash players. Oh, well scrambled. Yes. Finally, Alison plays a brilliant winner down the backhand wall. And both players acknowledge the appreciation of the crowd, shake hands, thank the referee, and throw the ball at the referee in the process. Absolutely thoroughly enjoyable game of squash. So now we know three of the semi-finalists in the ladies section. Millie Tomlinson from England, Georgina Kennedy from England, and Alison Thompson from England. World 48, World 72, and World 82. And there's an English girl in the final qualifying as well, Rachel Chadwick, who looked very well, beating Alexander Fuller from South Africa last night. But she's a qualifier, so she'll do well to be able to live with Anna Kilmondova. That game is scheduled to start at 5:45 in an hour's time. Yes, time goes on you when you're having fun. But now, the two bronze.